You're listening to Hotep Ish with your host, Dawan B. Intelligent Ish Talk, Intelligent Shit Talk, where we balance the profound with the profane. Political satire, celebrity and expert guests, information and entertainment, conversation and solutions. Leave your feelings at the door.
What up, y'all? What up, y'all? I'm here. I just had to do some. I'm over here doing some last minute verifications. Right after I went live, I realized that I read Drake's birthday wrong. He's a jack of hearts, not a queen of hearts. So the thumbnail that you see right now says queen of hearts. No. On second check, homie's a jack of hearts. And so, yeah, I'm glad I pointed that out because that wouldn't have been good. Y'all came back to me like, that ain't Drake. But I would have felt it. Just like, you know, because sometimes, there have been times that I have, like, made mistakes and read people's birthdays, like read the wrong birthday. Sometimes when you're doing that, when I'm doing it, when I'm doing it, it's like I'll be getting this this kind of tinge when I'm doing it. And it's like I'll be reading it, and and don't get me wrong, we all share a lot of the same aspects. So don't get me wrong, we do share a lot of the same aspects. Thing is, you know, you could be getting certain parts right, but like, nah, it'll be something where it's just like not hitting. You'll be like, that kind of sound like me, but, and I'll be sitting there looking like a dumbass. So, yeah, when you do these readings, you want to make sure it's right. So, I'm actually over here changing the thumbnail right now. While you guys are coming on in the chat room, I'm not reading the chat room yet because I got Canva open. So, I can change this thumbnail up. And I don't know why the fuck this thing ain't downloading. Do I got to do it on my phone? What the hell's going on, Canva? Do I got to do it on my phone? Shit. This shit just stuck on download. So what I need y'all to do is, here we go. What I need y'all to do, there it is. I can download it from my phone. That's what I'm going to do. My computer tripping. This shit. You ever have some shit on downloading and it's just stuck at the end? Like, what the fuck, man? All right, cool. Let me airdrop that to myself. Is that the airdrop? There it is. There's the thumbnail. That look better, y'all? That look better? There we go. Save the camera roll. There we go. Save the camera roll. Done. Here we go. Here we go. We in business now. So here we go. Now let me go to my stories. And let me go to my stories and let me hit delete. Delete from both, nigga. Yeah. I don't like having fucked up shit out there. Because there'd be a whole bunch of you weirdo ass niggas on the internet. Let me see. There we go. One second. While I'm doing this, make sure y'all... there we go. I'll put some other music on. There we go. Some preaching music. There we go. So let me go on over to Instagram. And let me change that photo up. There we go. So we talking about Drake right now. Drake is a jack of hearts. For those of you who don't know what a jack of hearts is, what I'm doing right here, what I'm doing is I am doing the ancient art of cardology, where we use the playing cards, yes, the same playing cards that you play poker and blackjack with. We use those playing cards to chart a person's life, chart your path, chart your children's path. That's what it's about. It's an ancient calendar. And we can read businesses, read relationships, read all kind of dope ass shit. And y'all know me. I like to take some time reading my cards and doing my cards. And I was just saying earlier, I want to read cards, but I didn't know what the fuck I wanted to read. I didn't know, now I know what to read, because I was looking at a... You know, the other day, all week, I've been basically talking about a lot of music stuff and, you know, what's going on in the music industry. We see what's going on with the hijacking of our music history and the dumbing down of our music. And so, you know, I have my music documentary coming out and everything, but we see what's been going on. We see what's been going on. And, you know, these artists that have been sort of hijacking our sound and appropriating our culture, they've sort of been in my crosshairs when it comes to the music side of the game. I wasn't even thinking about reading Drake, you know, but then when I was around here earlier, I was like, you know what? Let me read this nigga. What card is he? And now I see he's a Jack of Hearts. That card right there, that makes a hell of a lot of sense. Queen of Hearts made a lot of sense too on the emotional side of the game. But these Jack of Hearts are some emotional ass niggas too. Let me tell you something about the Jack of Hearts. The Jack of Hearts is the Captain Save a whole card. Excuse me to my Jack of Hearts friends out there. I got Jack of Hearts friends. I got Jack of Hearts clients. I got a couple Jack of Hearts, and they're all different. No two Jack of Hearts are the same. It's only six of them. Birthday starting in July. Go to my website, breakthroughcards.com. If you go to breakthroughcards.com, my website, you can find what your card is and where your card is and more about your personality. Go to breakthroughcards.com and then look for your birthday at breakthroughcards.com. Play around. Jump around on the site. See what your birthday is. Find out something about yourself. Find out something about your silly ass. You dig? I might actually do like many pre-recorded readings and put them up on my website for y'all to download. I still got my incense and ashtrays shit up here in my bag. But excuse me for being rude. Welcome, chat room. I appreciate y'all for joining. Welcome to the chat. We are here doing a live reading of Drake. And we're going to find out why he is who he is. And one thing I like about Cardology is, you know, it's a chance for, because we can all, including me, hell, sometimes especially me, get too judgmental of people and you want people to change or be a certain way. Or you may look at people and be like, why are they that way? At the end of the day, we all got to remember, we are all playing our own cards out, you know? You got a deck of cards to play. I got a deck of cards to play. We've all been handed a deck of cards. See, for people that like to call stuff like this spookism, remember this. You've been using the language of cardology your whole life. When they say, hey, I'm just playing my cards out. How many times have you heard somebody say that? Yeah. Did you know you actually had a set of cards? 13 of them. 13 card spread. That can decipher the different aspects of your personality. So what we're going to do here is we're going to go down the different aspects of Drake's personality. And we're going to read them. And we're going to see. Hold on. There we go. We're going to look and see why he is the way he is. And my normal screen that I put up there so you guys can see the cards is not working. For some reason, my print screen button on my computer is just like acting hella weird right now. So I can show you guys Drake's card spread. Well, while I'm letting that thing go, salute to the chat room. Everybody up here, Ebony, Khalil, Linus, Devin, Kid Cash, appreciate y'all for joining. Yeah, so we about to get up in here. This thing ain't saving, so I'm going to go to backup plan number two. And we're going to pull up Drake's cards. And when I'm done reading Drake, I'm going to read some of y'all. You know, of course, Cash App's to the front. You don't have to Cash App me if you don't want to. But if people are Cash Apping me, they going to get put to the front of the line. You dig? And so just let you know. Also, before I get started, I got something that's going to be premiere for y'all tomorrow online. I need y'all to look at my documentary, Pilot. It's getting ready to drop real. My documentary short is getting ready to drop real soon. And I'm going, no, this is the wrong one. Not this. I don't want that. I don't want that. No. That's not what I want. I don't want to show y'all my goddamn Twitter space from yesterday. And salute to everybody that watched yesterday's Twitter space. That's not what I want to show y'all. Where is what I wanted to show y'all? Where the fuck? I got to show y'all this as we get started. I got my documentary. I got the reel is ready to go. And I thought I was about to show it to you, but no, something else came down. I'm gonna wait till we get further into the show. I'm gonna download it, and then when we get to the point, to the midway point, the break point, after I'm done reading Drake, and before I take some of you guys as it reads, we will premiere the documentary short. We will premiere that at the midway point when I'm done reading Drake and before I take some of you guys reading. How about that? I don't want to slow shit down. Anyway, and also, I will have a special discount for those people who watch later on in the show. I have a nice discount on my readings, but you can't. I'm not telling it to y'all right now. I'm not telling it to y'all right now. You're going to have to wait. You're going to have to wait until the end, my friend. Not the end, but the mid. Here it is. It downloaded. But you're going to have to wait till the midway point to find out my special nice discount on my readings. I'm not going to give you guys that discount code yet. You can book for the full price if you want to. Now I ain't going to stop you, but the discount code's going to come later on. But watch this real quick. Hi. What's your name, fool? My name is DeJuan Brown, creator of the Black American Influence on Music and Culture.
So what you saying?
I come from the field of working with children. And in working with children, I've seen that there's so many young Black kids who really don't understand where we come from.
I'm from Africa. I'm from Crenshaw Mafia.
As he creates a detailed timeline on how through Jim Crow, we created every form of music from rock to pop to bebop to hip hop and more.
I put together this tree because it seems to be an all-out assault on the history of Black American music.
You damn right.
We've always had music that talked about love.
Love and you is easy cause you're beautiful.
That talked about life.
Back to life, back to reality.
That talked about the agonies of life. That talked about the hardships of life. When it comes into art music, when you put that drum set down, drums, bass, keys, kick drum, snare, hi-hat, you go from swinging your hips left and right to the salsa rhythm to bobbing your head on a one and a two. That's the effect the drum set has. So when we talk about hip-hop and what it is, it's an extension of the music and the instrumentation that our forefathers created.
Check out the live stream premiere of the documentary short, It's Bigger Than Hip Hop, The Black American Family Tree, and Q&A, a fundraiser to create a series detailing music's evolution. Go to DeJuanB.com for streaming passes and crowdfunding.
There we go. So join the movement, everybody. Join the movement. We getting this shit popping. And on this first episode, this only one I'm showing y'all what I got. But in the future episodes when we record, we got some names for y'all. We got some names, but this ain't about the names. This is about the substance of the material. So yeah, I appreciate and I look forward to y'all's support on that project right there. So let's get into it. Let's get into it. I appreciate you. Y'all like that in the chat room? Oh yeah, you gonna like the whole thing. I packed a fuck ton of information in less than 30 minutes. Like it's a lot of information in less than 30 minutes. So if I could pump as much information as I pumped in 30 minutes, like you guys really need to back this project because you're going to see how much information I pumped in 30 minutes. And so, on my own dime. So you're going to see what, you're going to be able to anticipate what I'll be able to do as I'm able to invite esteemed guests on to be a part of the project and get some music licensing on some of the stuff that I want to do and some actual footage licensing. Imagine how much it's going to be in that. All right. And if you look in this documentary, it's still based in love because everything that I do is based in love. There are two ways to get people's attention. There are two ways to get things done. That's through fear and love. Most people operate on a fear principle. I don't. I operate on a love vibration. I ain't trying to scare nobody. I ain't trying to harm nobody. I ain't trying to hoit nobody. Like our old grandparents said, hoit. I ain't trying to hoit nobody. Ain't going to hoit nobody. But I do love black people. I love black children. I love my grandmama, you know? This is for my grandmother. This is my grandfather who just died last year. Who told me Count Basie used to practice in his uncle's living room. This is for my family. It's for your family. They didn't go through all that stuff to be forgotten about. I love them. So through love and honor for my ancestors and the present, those of us alive, my love for the future, and my love for humanity and the truth, this project must get done. And with that said, I appreciate the chat. My man Major just sent me a text. All the graphics you see on the Bigger Than Hip Hop, that's done by Major. Major said he's in the chat room. I don't know where you at in the chat, Major. I don't know if you're on Twitter or if you're over on YouTube. I got a bunch of things going on, but salute to Major in the chat. He did my the Bigger Than Hip Hop graphics. Well, anyway, let's go into Drake's cards. The life, the thing isn't saving the other PDF that I want to save. But my love is for humanity and the truth. And my firm belief is, hey, my ancestors got me. And that's who I'm honoring. My grandmother, my grandfather, that's who I'm honoring. If you're one of the people that ain't got ancestors you honor, then hey, honor, then find some. Because hey, we got plenty of them. And we have not been giving our ancestors enough honor. And part of honor of our ancestors gatekeeping our culture. Finding out who this is, capitalizing off of our culture. So one of the main culture capitalists, and chat, y'all can stamp this to the 24 minute mark when I get into reading Drake. You can timestamp in mods when it's over with, please. At 24 minutes when I get to the part where I'm reading Drake. So Drake is born October 25th, 1986. That is a Jack of Hearts day. Jack of Hearts people are, that's the Captain Save-A-Hole card. You know, again, no disrespect to my Jack of Hearts clients, my Jack of Hearts friends, but y'all know what I'm talking about. The Jack of Hearts, it can do too much as far as like going to saving the wrong kind of people. The Jack of Hearts is also the preacher card. When I think of preachers, I think of the Jack of Hearts because they know how to smooth you with their personality and charm. It's one of the most charming cards in the deck. It's also a fixed card. When I say fixed, my cardology students know what I mean. And salute to all my cardology students in the room. Press number one if you're one of the students. I appreciate y'all. Star, you in the room. Star, you doing a good job with this cardology course so far. I appreciate you. I can tell through the questions that you ask. But so we, so when you're dealing with the Jack of Hearts, you're dealing with somebody who knows how to appeal to you through their charm. They're so, and when they know how to tap into that, they're fixed cards. Fixed, when we're reading cards, there's, I'll show you when I get to, well, I can show you now. As a matter of fact, I can show you now. Let me go to the other spread he can do. They're fixed cards. Cards, every year, when I do yearly readings, everyone's card shuffles around every year in a different placement. All but three cards shuffle around. And Drake is one of the three fixed cards. One of the three fixed cards. Fixed meaning, like when I show you right here, all of these shuffle around. Drake's card doesn't shuffle. The Jack of Hearts don't shuffle. The Eight of Clubs don't shuffle. And the King of Spades don't shuffle. What does that mean? What that means is, when you're dealing with one of these three cards, the King of Spades, Jack of Hearts, Eight of Clubs, they don't move for nobody. The Jack of Hearts moves for nobody. The world revolves around the Jack of Hearts. It's in the Venus position in Saturn. So that means it's a highly emotional card. He's a very, this card is ruled by his emotions. And it's very stubborn. Very stubborn. So Drake's a very stubborn person. Emotionally ruled. And stubborn isn't neither bad nor good. Stubborn just is. See, watch, I'm about to see. Notice the placements of these cards. See where this Queen of Spades is and these other cards? Watch when I change the year. Watch, see where all these other cards are? Watch the rest of these cards shuffle. See how they all shuffle? Drake's card never shuffles. So that means, if you're a Jack of Hearts person, you're the kind of person that you don't bid, you don't budge. You stand strong and stay strong in who you are for all my Jack of Hearts people out there. We also have to play our role in life. You know, I don't get into judging people good, bad, or indifferent. Everyone just is. And once you understand that we all just is, then you play your own fucking role, you know? Jack of Hearts' birthday is July 30th. August 28th, September 26th, October 24th, November 22nd, and December 20th. Those are your Jack of Hearts birthdays. So it's not that many of them. We're in, these are your hearts. Your hearts' birthdays only start to come around this time of year. And so we're in heart season right now as far as birthdays go. We're in spade season. We're in diamond season right now. But this is where a lot of your heart's birthdays are. But we're in diamond season, fall. Fall represents the diamonds. The winter represents the spades. So back to Drake and what all that means for him. All right, let's get through the rest of his cards. He has a Nine of Clubs in Mercury. That means he, you gotta watch what he say. The Nine of Clubs is a card that can say what it needs to say to get in any position it needs to get in. See, the reason why it's important that you know your card and you know your card spread is once you understand your cards and where you are, you understand your advantages, what you can work for your advantage in your life. You understand where your deficits are, the things you need to the areas of your game you need to sharpen, and you learn how to really work your natural assets that God gave you. That's really what reading cards is about, understanding your cards is about. Understanding your cards is understanding what the things in life you've been given and the tools you've been given to navigate do where you got to get to. And he got a 9 of clubs in Mercury. So that means he one thing he can play to his advantage is he can say what he needs to say to get what he wants to get. And the Jack of Hearts is a complicated card because on one hand, they're sensitive, but on the other hand, a lot of Jack of Hearts people are full of shit. Not all of y'all. Not all y'all. But if a Jack of Hearts person chooses to be full of shit, they be getting away with it. You know, like sometimes you be like, you look at people and you be like, God damn, how they do that? If I said that, a nigga would have murked me. How the fuck? Them Jack of Hearts people, they can do things and get away with things most people can't get away with. You know? These people can get away with things, boy. I swear to God. And Drake can do that. And he has a 9 of spades in Venus. What that means is, for Drake, with that 9 of spades, he is somebody that he's had a his mom his relationship with his mom is complicated. Venus tells me a lot about your relationship with your mom. Although it's his mom's connection, his mom's side of the game that got him hooked up and got him to the top of the world musically, they have a complicated relationship. I'm sure there's a lot of tension there. Her high expectations of him, you know, when I read that 9 of spades, he had a whatever it looked like on the outside, it was tough. Mom disappointed him a lot. Even though she, I don't know if it was either her lying to him, I don't know. But there was something there that was a strong woman in his presence that he had a very complicated relationship with. This also a card of making it, like a Cinderella ending card, the 9 of spades, meaning a lot of you put in the work and you have a big end. Like Drake has had a grand career. 9 of spades is very difficult card to get to, and he's gotten to it. So Drake is definitely playing to the high side of his cards. He, in some ways, like as far as his public success, I don't know how it is in his private life. Looking at his cards, being a Jack of Hearts, his private life isn't as champagne poppy, skipty to do as it appears. And because we all got things we got to deal with. He don't have financial worries. He don't have worries about women and a lot of the things that most people worry about. But he has worries on another level. There's a lot of heartbreak going on there. Then he got that 2 of hearts with his Mars. 2 of hearts is your relationship with your father, and it's your challenges in life. So Drake, with the 2 of hearts in his Mars, where his conflict is, that means emotional connections are a problem for him. 2 of hearts is all about a union, love, partnership, but Mars is challenging. So that means to tell me, interpersonal, like romantic one-on-one relationships are a major challenge for Drake. They are. He probably had the right one 3 or 4 different times. And for whatever reason, it fumbled off. Didn't work. Didn't happen either. She left him or he did something stupid. Whatever reason, because the two hearts card of soulmates. So with it being in a Mars position, that tells me he's having challenges finding a soulmate. If he had that same 2 of hearts, say in his Venus position, then it might be it'd be a lot easier for him to find a soulmate. But would it have been in Mars position, it's tough, but it doesn't mean it can't happen. it means part of his destiny is to make to is to solve whatever emotional traumas linked to whatever traumas dealing with his mom for him to grow. See, when we play, when we live our life's cards, our life's cards are a story. They're a story in which and how we live life. Complicated relationship, challenge with his mom, issues with women, and his relationship with his father is complicated. He probably has an emotional connection with his father, but not much on top of that. Like, I think Drake definitely has an emotional connection with his dad. Like, but in that two of hearts position is in trying to, his dad was, probably wasn't as present as he wanted him to be. His father probably wasn't as present as Drake wanted him to be. So he has an issue with union and connection. So that's his challenge. But challenge does not mean impossible. It means that's the issue in your life laid down in front of you for you to solve and overcome. So through that, he gets into his Jupiter position. That's the King of Hearts. What's going to happen is Drake gets a little bit older as he gets into his 40s. When he gets into his early 40s, about 5 years from now, he's going to be in his King of Hearts part of his life. King of Hearts is... That's another reason why Jack of Hearts people are so able to emotionally connect to people. King of Hearts people is another, that's another card that's a hard time settling down. He has two very strong cards when it comes to attraction. So that Jupiter position card, King of Hearts, that means he manipulating the hearts of others comes easy to him. That's what that means. And you can see he does that. Drake's fan base is real. They fuck with him. And I'm not even mad at it. You know what I mean? Drake's fan base really does fuck with him. And you see why that King of Hearts, Jupiter's expansion is what you have to give. Is what you give to the world is Jupiter. Is what you give to yourself. And this is where what makes Drake a double threat. That King of Diamonds in Saturn. The King of Diamonds is a master of business card. And Saturn is how it rules how you live your life. So that tells me Drake being where he is by no mistake. We could talk about his family connections, and I'm sure those exist. But he himself is a very smart businessman. That King of Diamonds in Saturn. He's an extremely intelligent businessman. The King of Diamonds in Saturn also indicates why he is the way he is with his music. As far as, this is Mr. Champagne Poppy. Damn near, I don't want to use a word. But heard what Joe Budden said. What's up with all these young ass girls you be with, man? You know, the King of Diamonds is it's the reason why that nightclub in Miami is named the King of Diamonds, yo. That's also the card of the strip club, man. You know. And then Drake being on the 24th, he's on that Libra Scorpio border. The border of balance and cravings. So you know he wild. He don't know how to crave. With him being on the cusp of those two signs, it's probably best that brother do stay single. You know what I mean? And he has a Six of Hearts in Uranus. That's another emotional balance, slowing things down emotionally, harmonizing emotion. He has that in Uranus, so that means emotional stability is a major challenge for him. The Six of Hearts is very giving. It's creative and it's also giving. So I'm sure he's generous with those around him. I'm sure Drake's friends are well taken care of. You know, I'm sure of it. But it has a hard time finding emotional satisfaction. Yeah, so if you know, anybody know out there that know, if you know Drake, tell him the reason why he having issues finding emotional satisfaction because he's setting the bar too high. You know, for himself. Because again, them Jack of Hearts, they kind of get off on being the captain save a hole. They like helping people out that are destitute. They got to understand that. Nah, that's cool and all, but you got to help yourself out. Open up your heart to yourself. He had a Four of Clubs in Neptune. That's another creative card. That's harmonizing and balancing and business. And yeah, he's the reasonable one. Drake is a reasonable person. That's what I see in his cards. He's a reasonable person. Two of Diamonds, Pluto. He is, that's another master business card. So he has a Two of Diamonds and a King of Diamonds. Those are two wonderfully great business cards to have. If you're a Jack of Hearts person, you have the cards of someone who can dominate and master business. The only reason why a Jack of Hearts wouldn't be dominating in business is one, they're unaware they have that power. Two, they're afraid of wielding that power. Those are the two things that are getting your way, Jack of Hearts. You're not even knowing. You know it's there, but you don't quite know yourself. Two, the fear. You know? Fear, don't be afraid. The Jack of Spades. Result, reward, another card that can say whatever the hell it wants to say to get what it needs to get. That tells me he can say whatever the hell he needs to say to get what he wants to get. Eight of Clubs is his lesson. That's another fixed card. He has two of the three fixed cards in the deck in his personal card spread. So that means he's supposed to be immovable, like a rock. Six of Diamonds and Moon. That tells me he does see, you know, he is Drake's. Seems like a fairly fair guy. He's a fair guy. He's, you know, and if he's not, when he's not being fair, he pay for it. Karmically. So watch yourself. And then a Four Spades in transformation. That means he can literally get through anything he think he needs to get through. Yeah, so Drake. So this is Drake's yearly spread. So next year, Drake, anybody knows him, he's gonna be in the Queen of Spades year. Next year's a karmic year for him. That the Queen of Spades, watch out for judgment. The next year's not gonna go the way he wants it to. Drake's gonna be in the news next year. And for the first time in his career, he's gonna be in the news for things that aren't favorable to him, right? That just jumped out of me on screen. Drake is gonna be on the news for something that, for the first time in his life, doesn't benefit him next year. What else do I see in this card spread? Nine of Diamonds, a lot of difficulties. He's going to be dealing with a lot next year. Five of Hearts, Saturn tells me whatever it is that's going to be happening, it's going to be in the public view. He's going to have some issue, and it might be issues with the heart, but matters of, you know, I don't know what it is, relationships, I don't know. But it's going to be some kind of scandal, something that's going to put him in the news unfavorably next year. So he better watch it. Ace of Spades and Pluto, that means he got a transformation coming. But that transformation tells me that Ace of Hearts and transformation, okay, that tells me that he's going to be going through a rough transition next year. But he does have a new beginning coming his way. death of some deep, the Ace of Spades and Pluto, it's the death of some deep issues. Some shit that's going on way down deep inside. But a lot of it's going to play out in public. Huh, this is interesting. This is interesting. Again, this is for entertainment purposes for the for those out there. We reading Drake's cards. Just seeing what's going on. Having a little bit of fun. You dig? I need y'all to, you know, y'all want to get red? Here we go. Dollar sign DeJuan Brown, hit me up. Oh, I just got one. And call in. I'm actually gonna open up the phone lines for some of y'all to call in. I like reading people live. So y'all can get some genuine reactions from people. Y'all wanna do some live readings? Yeah, I think I'm gonna do some lives. Oh, let me give you my discount. If you go to breakthroughcards.com and you book now, book this week only. This week only, you can 30% off all readings. 30%. If you go to breakthroughcards.com, type in the product code 30, spell out the word 30 in all lowercase. 30% off all readings. That's for people who stick with me deep into these shows. So if you want to book a reading, not all our readings. So that basically puts you right there at a 30-minute reading. That applies to the hour readings. An hour and a half readings. And it also, quiet is kept, that also applies to my 3-reading package. If you want to book 3 readings in a block, for those of you who get readings regularly, 30% off also applies to the 3-reading package. All right? But it's 30% off all readings for that. But that's for those who booked this week. And that's a salute and a shout out to all of you out there who listen deep on into the show. So product code 30. And you get 30% off your shit. All right. All right. Somebody just hit me up in the Cash App and they say, your birthday is what? Your birthday is 12. No, not equal. 1. Are you a little young ass nigga? 1996? Shit, nigga. This motherfucker was born between the time of Biggie and Tupac. One was gone, one was still here. Goddamn, young ass nigga. All right, December 1st. You are a 4 of diamonds. Values mean everything to you. You have to be rock solid with your values. Don't compromise for chicken change. Don't compromise for chicken change. Make sure that you're honest in your dealings, all right? That's really big for you. You can't get away with bullshitting people like that as a 4 of diamonds. You have that Queen of Hearts and Saturn. That means give and give generously. Like, you know, through your giving will be a blessing. But giving can sometimes be hard because you 4 of diamonds motherfuckers don't give a fuck. Y'all truly are the, like, some not giving a fuck ass people. So, yeah, that's for you. Make sure that you give. That's where your blessings are. All right, cool. Starlet, let me see. Okay, let me get the birthday. Thank you for the Cash App. Your birthday is, come on now. Oh, Halloween. Dun-dun-dun. She's born on Thriller Day. It's close to midnight. Why don't I know what card is Halloween? You didn't give me a year, so it don't matter. We're not doing a week. Only time it matters when you give me a year, the only time it matters if you gave me a year or not is if I'm reading like what's going to be happening to you that week or that year. If you want a cardiology reading for the year or for your next 7 years, then of course I would need your birthday, because we can break things down in your 7 year. Is a child coming? Will you get married? Any business partnerships coming your way? All that stuff can be charted and tracked in your personal reading. But okay, so you are a four of hearts. That's union of heart. You somebody who you love beyond understanding, and you long for emotional love balance, and you are balanced. You're somebody who, when you attract the right one, they can you can calm them down emotionally. If this is a situation, it's a whole bunch of people fighting outside and bullshitting, a whole bunch of rigmarole going on, you know how to bring harmony to the situation, bring chill to the situation. And you're four diamonds on your Mercury, so that means balance means a lot to you too. Balance means everything to you. You can't operate. You got that two fours and a two. Oh my God, and an eight. Oh, I'm looking at I'm looking further down your cards. We got an eight of hearts in Mars. That means as much as you want to love, love can be conflicting. You know what I mean? You can sometimes put too much emotion into it to the wrong people. Watch out for putting too much emotion into the wrong people. Things come slow for you. Six of clubs in Jupiter, six of spades in Saturn. Things come slow for you. So you got to be patient. Patience is big for you, okay? Okay? Things don't happen fast. Be patient. You're four. Chill. Relax. All right? That's the biggest thing. Relax. Don't fret. Don't fret. Don't want. Chill. And don't be so damn preachy either. Four hearts people could be hella preachy and ruthless. Don't be like that, all right? Be nice. Play nice. Don't be ruthless and don't be preachy, all right? Play nice with people. All right? Cool. All right, next. That was for October 30th. Let me do somebody in the chat room. Auntie Crusher, 11/29/1979. Cash App, I'll get to you next. Oh, that's crazy, Auntie Crusher. You have four hearts also. Four hearts has so few birthdays. That's crazy. How many birthdays does four hearts have? And I just read, wow, it's only three four of hearts in the chart. And I got two four hearts birthday readings y'all want me to do. Well, for you, Auntie Crusher, most of what I said for the other person too. But you are going into that Sagittarius season. So you got to be, don't, you emotions, you got to really guard your emotions, because the Sagittarius can get really, y'all get like when you get emotionally charged on something as a Sagittarius one, that could really go. And as a four hearts, you know, when you feel things emotionally, if business wise, if just say you have a decision you want to make, Auntie Crusher, business wise, if you feel an emotional charge to it, that's the direction you want to go. But when it comes to your emotion on the downside, you being too emotionally charged can get you in a messed up situation. So watch it. But use that emotional energy that you have as an indication on whether or not to go left or right. Sometimes we reach this crossroad, this crossroad in our life, or with a particular situation, and we either go left or go right. For a four hearts person, you make sure that if you're feeling emotionally charged towards something, that you follow that's the direction that you go in. If it's a decision to make, this or that. All right, 10/3/1996. Another 1996 ass nigga? God damn. me see here. 10/3/1996. That's why. 10/03. Here we go. What the fuck? 10. Let me just... 10/03/1996. There we go. Six of diamonds. Truth be told, you a six of diamonds. That's all about being fair. You're a fair person. You're a very fair person. Be fair to yourself, though. That's a challenge. Sometimes you're more fair to other people than you are yourself. And that's out of harmony. That's out of balance. That's when you find yourself messing yourself up and getting yourself fucked up. When you've been more fair to other people than you've been fair to yourself. Because you're a fair card. So be fair to yourself, all right? That's the biggest advice I can give you. Be more fair to you than you are to other people. And you'll be blessed. But if you spend most of your time being considerate of other people, more so than yourself, you'll suffer those consequences internally. And, you're a just person. You know, you're very creative, too. All right. So yeah, follow your spirit, man. All right. Next up from the Cash App, Sunny Weathers. That's a funny. I like that's a dope name. Hey, is that can't be a real name. That gotta be like the online persona name. 1994. Five of diamonds. You said you want to know what next year is looking like for you. The yearly readings require a little more math, my brother. But let me see here. How old are you, Sunny Weathers? What's your age? I don't feel like doing no fucking math right now, man. Don't trip. Come on, I don't feel like doing no math right now. 1994. You're 29. All right. You're 29. So let me go to age spread, 29. And let's see what your year is looking like. All right. Come on now. There we go. Hold on. I'm having technical issues here. There we go. The fuck is going on? The hell? No. There we go. 29. There we go. 29, and your card is a five of diamonds. Alright, so you say you wanna know what your next year looking like? Where's five of diamonds on the spread? Where are you, five of diamonds? Where the fuck is you at? Here you go. Okay, I can tell you right now, next year is 29. Gonna be a little bit of a challenge for you, partner. It's gonna be a little bit of a challenge for you, but nothing you can't get over. It's gonna be some blessing. See, as a five of diamonds, you're a natural salesperson, but you're reaching a fork in the road. What you gonna be going at? I'm sure you can sell ice to Eskimo, Sunny Weathers. You can sell sand at the beach if you so choose. You coming up on a year where you're gonna emotionally harmonizing. Look for new love next year. Look for somebody to connect to. There might be a connection coming your way this year. Somebody new in your life, a new relationship coming your way. That Four of Hearts and Mercury. So be open to it. If it's a chick coming your way, or if you're a woman, if it's a man coming your way, whatever you're attracted to, if it's somebody coming your way, if somebody's coming your way, be open to it. right. I got a little more. Next, I'm going to get back to you, Sonny Weathers. But next up, we're going to have Amir Miller, Iris Peoples, and Quentin Robinson. Y'all going to be, y'all in the queue. Y'all in the queue. I'm on Sonny Weathers right now. So you have, there's some kind of a union coming the way this year. Something in a way, and it's going to be a positive thing, all right? It's going to be a positive thing. Open your heart to it. Seven of Hearts and Pluto. That means there's going to be some boundary issues later on in the year. Watch out for that. All right. Watch out, you know, be open, but don't cross, but watch out for people trying to cross your boundaries. Okay. Ace of Diamonds and Jupiter, Eight of Diamonds and Venus. Oh yeah. So, Eight of Diamonds and Venus tells me that you could be getting, you know, this could be a good, pretty good year for you financially. If you want, it's gonna be a challenging year, but it's gonna be rewarding. Put it like that. It's gonna be a challenging year, but it's also going to be a rewarding year for you. Okay, so make sure you got. Oh yeah, you got the Ten of Spades, and as a cosmic lesson. Oh yeah, that. Oh yeah, I can guarantee you're gonna have a lot of hard work this year, buddy. But it's going to be, don't fret. You good, all right? You good. So hopefully that works for you. All right. Next up, Amir 10-23-78. Why am I looking so hard? Oh, we're killing my eyes out. I got my phone on, but you know the part where the background, I have the background all the way like on low, and it's goddamn dark as hell in this room. Over here struggling for no goddamn reason. Shit. All right, Amir, 12-3-1978. Two of Diamonds. You're smart. Yeah, you have a good business mindset. You do. But the thing that stops you, Sagittarius, Two of Diamonds, is fear gets in your way of really making a big impact. You can make a big impact, but you got it. Two of Diamonds is a hard-working card. I'm sure you worked a lot, but your biggest issue, what I'm seeing, is being quitting before the payoff got there. As a Two of Diamonds, whatever you start, you have to finish. If you feel like you've been working and working too long, but you know your heart had you into whatever that is, keep working until it's done, all right? That's one of the biggest things I want to say to you, Amir, is work until it's completed, work until it's done. You got a Jack of Spades and Mercury, so that tells me you can say whatever you need to say to get whatever you want. Excuse me, I just hit the blunt. That tells me you can say whatever you need to say to get what you want. Just make sure you're on the up and up with that. You got that skill set. Just make sure you use it for something constructive for you, okay? Non-nefarious means. All right? Do it. Make sure you're constructive with it. Eight of Clubs and Venus. Very fixed. Very focused. When you focus on something, your thing's being fixated. You get fixated on things and focus. What you have to avoid is being fixated and focused on petty shit. Make sure whatever you're fixated and focused on is something that's constructive to you. Make sure it's something that's going to put some money in your pockets. Make sure it's on a vision or a goal that you have. Because if you're not focused on a vision or a goal, you get caught up in petty things that don't do nothing good for you, all right? So, but use that. Use that focus that you have, but use it on something that's going to put some money in your pocket. Use it for something that's going to put some money in your pocket. I appreciate the Cash App, Iris, but you didn't put a birthday in there. Are you in the chat room, Iris? If you're in the chat, throw that birthday in there if you want me to read you. I appreciate the Cash App, but you didn't put a birthday in here. So put a birthday up in the chat room. So Bruce, you said you tried to call in. The line is open. It should be. Which one of you in the chat room, in the Cash App, Bruce? Are you Quintus? Oh, is it Iris in the chat? Okay, 125 and 1982. Okay, Iris, you in the chat? Okay, you said, thank you, Moni. 125, 1982. Let me see. Is that another two of diamonds? Oh, one. That's crazy. You're two of diamonds also. Okay, you're two diamonds also. It's funny how shit worked. I've had two readings on the same card tonight. I don't know. Maybe that happens for a reason. So let me dig. Listen to how two different reading, how the same card can read different for two different people. Watch how the same card. Hey, caller, whoever that was calling in, call me back in about 2 minutes. Give me 2 minutes to read this. Give me 2 minutes to read this person. And then when I'm done reading, call right back in, caller, all right? I don't have a queue where I can put you on hold. Or if you want to call back, I can just put you on mute. That's what I do. This is what I do. What's up, caller? I'm gonna go ahead and mute you so I can finish reading this card that I'm gonna get to you next, all right?
It's all good.
Yeah, I can do that. I can do that. I do have that level of queue. Can't do that. So let's show you how this two of diamonds is different from the last two of diamonds. You are a two of diamonds going on that other side of the year that I'm drawing a motherfucker blank. I'm dyslexic, y'all. I'm dyslexic. I'm dyslexic. Aquarius. Aries, Aquarius, Aries. That crazy bitch Aries in the chat room. Yeah, some crazy motherfuckers. Excuse me when I get the two mixed up. I'm totally dyslexic. I'll know exactly what the hell I'm talking about, but I will use the wrong word sometime. Excuse my faults. But here's with you, Iris. You have a 10 of hearts in Saturn. So that means you got to follow your passion. Like you got to, your passion. Passion guides you. You got Michael Jackson at the heart. You're probably a Michael Jackson fan. I'm sure you relate to Michael Jackson, Iris. I'm sure you relate to Michael Jackson a lot. And you feel the connection in your heart. That's because you're very passionate about things. You care and you know how to emote, and through that is your blessings. The issue can be sometimes be is you guard your heart too much. And when I say too much, meaning you think you can be hurt, and fact of the matter is you can't be hurt. And that goes for everybody out there. None of us can be hurt. We only have experiences. We're bigger than who we are. But for you especially, you know, be open to opening your heart, okay? Be open to it. Because in that heart is a lot of passion, a lot of fire. And it's artistically, you're artistic. You're an artistic two of diamonds. You're creative. And through your heart, through your path, through the things you're passionate about, you create beautiful pieces of work, beautiful pieces of art. And make sure you keep that up, all right? That's where it is for you. Then you got that Ace of Hearts and Pluto. I mean, Two of Diamonds, you like unions, you like partnerships. But deep down inside, you also don't mind being alone. You don't mind being alone. You prefer partnerships, you prefer unions, because that's your Sun card. But your Pluto card, Ace of Hearts, you're fine. You know, you have a certain level of innocence to you, you know, that you keep buried down deep inside that you don't show to the world. And you barely show it to yourself. But it's there. It's there. It's there. All right? So make sure that you play your cards out and play them to your advantage. Because you have a lot of dope shit that's in store for you. You have a lot of stuff that's there for you. And you have that four spades in Jupiter. That means you're supposed to win. When you finally focus on what you need to focus on and you do it through completion, you're going to win. You have to win. All right? Hopefully that helps. All right, so now move on to the caller. What's up, caller? What's your name? Where you calling from?
Quintus. I'm calling from SAC.
Quintus from SAC. What's your birthday, man?
4/13/89.
04/13/89. Are you an eight of diamonds? That mean you clean, huh? Yeah. You walk out the house clean. Yeah, yeah.
When I
want to.
Huh? That's a yeah when I want to.
Yeah.
Calling to ask, because I'm pursuing some art, man. I just wanted to know if it was going to be worth pursuing, if it was going to feed anything.
You say you're pursuing some what?
Art.
Okay. Like, what kind of art? Like you want to know, like, if you want to buy like a certain piece of art or something like that, or if that's...
No, like music and like, I'm really into music and art and, like, I'm writing scripts and stuff. You know, you just got a bunch of ideas I need to get out. Wonder if they was gonna be worth pursuing.
Yeah, it's worth pursuing. And here's where you need to be focused, too. Your art's through your Neptune, so... You could get away with doing controversial pieces, controversial stuff that rings people up, that rings a bell. Your art, that's the tone of your art. It can be you can have a lot of success if you want to take on that tone in your art. I tell you, you got that three of diamonds in your Neptune. When it comes to your art, you also have that queen of clubs in your Jupiter. So that also means your art teaches. You have to teach through your art, okay?
Yes, sir.
Your art can't be based. You can't get away with art that's just. You can't get away with Cardi B style art is what I'm trying to say. You know? you can't get away with that. You have a queen of clubs in your Jupiter, so that means your art has to be substantive. Like, I can't tell you what to do. I can only tell you what energies are there for your success or your up and down. You know what I mean? Your heart, the fact that you asked me that question tells me, yes, you're supposed to be pursuing it or you wouldn't have called in. So I can tell you that before without picking up a deck of cards. But what I can tell you is through your art is it has to teach and it has to push boundaries. You had a three of diamonds in Neptune. So that means it has to push. The three of diamonds pushes boundaries. It's a shit starter. It's a shit starter. So is that... You a shit starter too sometimes when you want to be, ain't you?
The truth is gonna be what the truth is.
See,
I can't do nothing about that.
And you got that seven of hearts is your result reward. Seven of hearts is the year we in. Seven of hearts is another shit starting, boundary pushing card. So you gotta have substance and push boundaries. And if you stay in that, if you're in that substance pushing, boundary pushing lane. That's the street you need to be walking down. What art comes out of that is going to be successful and blessed, all right?
Appreciate you. I did have one more question.
Go ahead.
Okay, so I know some folks that be listening to readings and stuff. You pass by them, people talking all the time. I ain't never heard somebody getting a reading and the person be like, hey, look, you full of shit. You've been full of shit for the last 5 years. Get the fuck off my phone. Like, I've never heard that. Why does that not happen?
Let me tell you why. Because... We all live on a universal Wi-Fi signal. The same way our computers mimic our brains, Wi-Fi mimics and wireless internet mimics how we all communicate as a species, you know? And we're all tapped into this universal field. And those who know who take time to study how to tap that password, which is your birthday, whether it be through astrology, numerology, cardology, tarot. We all tapping into the same Wi-Fi signal. You dig? So your birthday is only going to have a particular signature for you. And if a person that's reading is open, they're going to be able to find what that is for you, wherever it is. That's why I never preach I'm the master of anything. And that's also why I teach cards. I don't want this thing to be a mystery. It's a mystery to us now because of this Western world that we were raised in that wants you to buy prescription pills for everything. You know what I mean? It's in their vested interest to make this stuff seem like it's full of shit. It's really not. And that's why I teach card classes. It's really not mystifying. It's very basic when you really start to break it down, you know? So the main reason why that doesn't happen is because whoever's reading you, if they're tapped in, they're going to tap into something that's tapped into you because they're just tapping into your password. That's all it is. I'm breaking through your Wi-Fi because I got your password, your birthday.
Right. I mean, I understand that, but I'd be like, you never hear, like, I'm not saying this to, oh, shit. All right, get off this block. I never hear somebody, like, really just be like, you ain't been doing shit right for the last X amount of time. You can change it, but you probably won't. Like, everybody that call can't be a good person, you know what I mean? And I'm like, well, where are the shitty people? Why is it always
they out
uplifting
there?
Uplifting message. Because I'm like, I'm like, yo, you don't watch your mouth if you don't feel like it. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, if he come across some bullshit people, I get off like,
I come across bullshit people all the time. But everybody got a high side and a low side to their cards. When I'm reading, I read to the high side what's open to you. But if you read me personally, I'll go right to people's bullshit in personal readings. I go right to their shit. I had one person I read, I was like, nigga, you be stealing. You know? And yeah, he like, yeah. You know?
Okay.
It's whatever comes up. But on a reading in front of, I don't know who's listening, I'm not going to put your business out there on the other end too, you know?
Got you.
I can read your stuff. Like there's certain things I can read in your cards right now. Like, I can read, like, with that King of Spades and your Mercury. That means you can really talk down to people. And you can really, like, you can hurt people with your words. You may not, intentionally or unintentionally. And you can, when you emotionally off balance, you can be very verbally abusive. And that's something you got to watch out for, but that only happens because you're eight. When you're off balance, when you're not off balance, you're good. You ain't tripping. Or the other way that plays out is if you get into a joking Jones and match with somebody, you can go for the kill shot. And you know.
Yeah, I don't play.
Yeah, you don't play. You don't play. And
there is no middles with me. Yeah, you right.
Yeah, see, but again, that comes down to how you play that card. You also the person, if somebody coming to you bullshitting, you're going to set the ass straight and tell them exactly what they need to hear. It's all a tool. It's like a razor blade. A razor blade could even cut that wall for you, to cut that edge you need to cut it for, or it can cut somebody's artery. What do you use it for? That's the other side of the game when it comes to these card readings, you know? But I'm glad you called and asked me that question.
Appreciate you. And you said that discount for this week, right?
Yeah, that put it. You put in a discount
Sunday
for the week
or Saturday, because I know you don't do Sunday readings.
I'll do Sunday readings if you email me. You know what I mean? I don't like to get booked on Sunday, but if I know far enough in advance, I'll do Sunday readings too. So, put it in. But you can book it for whenever you want. You know, you can book it. Someone booked this morning for a reading like next month. So, but use that 30% off.
Appreciate you, big dog. Y'all have a good night.
Yes, sir. Thanks for that question.
Yeah.
I like that question he asked, and that was a challenging question. You know, that wasn't, you know, when he asked me that question, if I gave y'all a bullshit ass answer, y'all be looking at me like, nigga, please. You know what I mean? Y'all have been looking at me like, nigga. I'm going to get to reading the next person, but give me like 20 seconds. All right, here we go, 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 here we go. That was a very business. So that was one of those business texts I had to get to now. But I really do appreciate you guys' patience, you know what I mean? I'm going to send one more text off, and then we're going to get right back to it. But, you know, y'all know how it is in business. Sometimes you got to get into something right now, you know, and that's what that is. I have two more Cash App readings that I got to do, and then I'll even take another one of you guys' calls. But DeAndre, I got your Cash App. If you want to call in, brother, and I can do it on the phone if you want me to, or I can do it here through the chat. So yeah. There we go. Let me turn this music back up. I'll be right back with you in 20 seconds. There we go, there we go, there we go. So next up. That Mario Soros had to witness a crime. No. If you guys go to my Twitter space yesterday that I put up from yesterday, yeah, I was sitting right here and there almost witnessed a crime. So screw you in the chat room, Mario. You a day late. But if y'all go to listen to yesterday's show, about 2 hours in, around the time that Tariq, I'm over here doing a Twitter space, and I don't even know Tariq that she's in the room. I just hear these niggas arguing, and you know how it is, your spirit. This is why you gotta follow your spirit. Let me preach y'all real quick about following your own spirit. I don't do spirituality for all kind of hocus pocus mumbo jumbo shit. This is for your own life and for your own good. Let me give you a testimony about how I followed my spirit yesterday, and I possibly saved somebody's life. Not bragging, because it was some bullshit. I was stressed the fuck up after that. But I was on my couch yesterday morning trying to decide, am I going to go on YouTube and go YouTube live with you guys, or will I do a Twitter space? See, when I come on YouTube, I'm bound to my computer. If I hear activity going on outside, I'm most likely not going to get up to find out what it is, because I'm bound to this mic. And I have my mic is dynamic, so you can't hear too much outside around noise unless it's extremely loud. So I got to talk directly into this mic. And so I can't really get up and do the show. And this mic is tethered to my computer. I don't have it to where I can walk around. So is that, or do a Twitter space where I can be on my phone and walk around if need be? My spirit told me do a Twitter space instead. On Sundays, especially Sunday morning, I'd rather be on my computer. My computer chair is quite comfortable, and I'm tied to a landline here in my computer. And so, but my spirit said, do a Twitter space instead. So I'm like, all right, cool, I'll do a Twitter space. So I did the Twitter space on music. And if you were in the Twitter space, press number one if you were in Twitter space yesterday, if you heard yesterday's Twitter space on here on YouTube. If you listen in the background, about an hour into the Twitter space, there's a lot of commotion going on in the background. And I'm like, fuck, man, these niggas is loud. And then like, I went back inside. And then when we get to right around the hour and a half mark, right around that hour and a half mark, you're starting to hear more and more commotion. And then that's like when all right, DeAndre, you can call in whenever you're ready, all right? That's when like I was like, let me get up real quick. And so I got up and my fucking neighbor, this nigga is young and dumb than hey y'all. I gotta lower my voice because my window's open. Turn your radio up. This nigga next to me is a young dumbass nigga, boy. This nigga stupid. So anyway, his girlfriend is yapping and fellas, watch your girl, man. Watch what kind of woman you with. You get with the wrong woman, she'll get your ass killed, yo. She was running her mouth, huffing and puffing, yipping and yapping. And this young man trying to break up the fight. And one thing led to another. Some people I don't even recognize coming out. And I step outside. I'm like, hey, yo, young nigga, get your ass in the house, man. These people coming around here I don't recognize. They don't look like they here to party with your ass. And right when I told his ass, because he's like, he's back to arguing with his girl. And I was like, man, fuck that bitch. Get in the house. And when I said that, he left just in time. Because that other dude looked like he was ready to whoop his ass. And that young man wouldn't have been able to handle that fade. He would not have been able to handle that nigga's hands. And they would have been a nigga. Like, that boy is about to get his ass whooped. I'm like, old boy came down. When you see a nigga come up to a fight, skipping, this young nigga saw a nigga skipping and wasn't ready to fight. If a nigga, let me tell you young dudes out there, if somebody comes running up to you skipping, they ready to fight. And this little nigga was not ready for that fade. Aries, you heard it? And so I muted my mic and I went outside and I had to get that nigga. Because he was about to get his ass whooped. And that shit would not have been pretty. Nigga, that motherfucker's forehead would have so many lumps and rumps and bumps on him. So I had to mute my Twitter space. And I possibly saved the motherfucker from the worst ass whooping he was ever going to get in his life. And then I came back to the Twitter space like nothing happened. I came back to the Twitter space like nothing happened. Like, yeah, back to business. All right, Elliot, 6/19/1974. DeAndre, I'm waiting for you to call in if you want to call in. 06/19/1974. Ninth King said, you heard it? Yeah. Jack of Clubs, Elliot. You have the full of shit card. I'm just playing, dog. I'm just fucking around. I'm just fucking with you. But when I say full of shit card, The Jack of Diamonds can say whatever. I mean, Jack of Clubs, man, that car can say what. I'm sure you be saying some bullshit. And you know, people be looking around like, and you don't ever get in trouble for the shit that you say. Like, you can say the most off the wall shit, and people don't even be wanting to fight you. And you be saying shit that's fight worthy. Not saying you haven't had to get into a scuffle or two in your lifetime over things that you said, but you get away with it. June 19th. You have a nine of diamonds in Mercury. So that means you be challenging people. You come around, you be, people can, that's another thing about you. You're not afraid to call somebody out on their bullshit. That's the thing about you Jack of Clubs people. You'll call somebody out on their bullshit. If you spend some bullshit on somebody, you'll be like, nigga, I'll beat your ass. Yeah, I don't get too many Jack of Clubs readings, man. Y'all Jack of Clubs are funny. I like being around Jack. Jack of Clubs people are fun to be around, too. They're fun to be around. But, and you also got that Two of Clubs in Mars. Oh, my God. So you will say what needs to be. Like, you have a hard time holding your tongue. You have a very hard time holding your tongue. If it's some bullshit going on, you're going to be the one to say it. You're going to be the one to say it June 19th. If you're an employee, I would hate to be a manager and have a Jack of Clubs as somebody. Because if you have a Jack of Clubs as somebody that works for you as a manager, you better be on point. Because that Jack of Clubs, they're very social, so you like them. I like people like you. But if your manager at work is bullshit, you're gonna be like, nigga, that ain't what the owners, man, that ain't what the manual say. You would call that shit out. And you got a King Clubs in Jupiter, so that means you a know-it-all. This nigga, is that you, Tyrone Johnson? Yeah, you a know-it-all ass nigga. And you got a Jack of Diamonds in Saturn. Ooh. So that means you really talk shit, because Jack of Diamonds is another shit-talking card. And you got it in Saturn. You shit-talking ass nigga. Creative as fuck. Very creative. And you on that cusp of Gemini Cancer. So that means you can speak from different points of view, different perspectives. You probably really creative. If you're creative, you probably like that game Grand Theft Auto. You know, like on Grand Theft Auto, you got like three or four different characters you play from. You probably like Grand Theft Auto, nigga. You got a Trevor side to you. You got a motherfucking Franklin side to you. I'm right, Tyrone. All right, cool. All right, yeah. Let's think about card readings. You just know who you are. DeAndre, I guess, ain't gonna call in. So let me, because I can't be here all night. Let me see here. What's your birthday, DeAndre Mosley? Let me see here. Let me go back to what is your birthday? You didn't put your birthday in. I'm going to wait for you to call in. DeAndre, can you call in? Because you didn't even put your birthday in a Cash App, so I wouldn't even know what to read any goddamn way. Yeah, but if you can't call in, just put your birthday in the Cash App. You sound right on point? Yeah. Use your voice to your advantage, man. Use your ability to shuck and jive. Shuck and jive your way into some bread. But make sure you do it on the up and up level. On the up and up side of the game. Shuck and jive your way into some coin, my brother. The call number is 323-744-7425. 323-744-7425. In the meantime, while, oh shit, what the hell am I doing? While he's calling in, I want y'all to watch this.
My name is DeJuan Brown, creator of the Black American Influence on Music and Culture.
So what you saying?
I come from the field of working with children. And in working with children, I've seen that there's so many young Black kids who really don't understand where we come from.
I'm from Africa. I'm from Crenshaw Mafia.
As he creates a detailed timeline on how through Jim Crow, we created every form of music, from rock to pop to bebop to hip-hop and more.
I put together this tree because it seems to be an all-out assault on the history of Black American music.
You damn right.
We've always had music that talked about love.
Love and you is easy cause you're beautiful.
That talked about life.
Back to life, back to reality.
That talked about the agonies of life. That talked about the hardships of life. When it comes into art music, when you put that drum set down, drums, bass, keys, kick drum, snare, hi-hat, you go from swinging your hips left and right to the salsa rhythm to bobbing your head on a one and a two. That's the effect the drum set has. So when we talk about hip-hop and what it is, it's an extension of the music and the instrumentation that our forefathers created.
Check out the live stream premiere of the documentary short, It's Bigger Than Hip-Hop, The Black American Family Tree, and Q&A, a fundraiser to create a series detailing music's evolution. Go to DeJuanB.com for streaming passes and crowdfunding.
That is coming out next month on y'all asses. What's up, Carl? Is this DeAndre?
Yes, it's DeAndre.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. How you doing today, brother?
Pretty good. Pretty good. Just had to go off for work.
I get it. So let me see here. What did my thumbnail go? All right, go ahead. So what's your birthday?
Oh, May 21st, 1995.
You said what? May 21st?
Yes, sir.
Oh, 21st, 1995?
Yes, sir.
I put 98. The hell am I doing? There we go. May 21st?
1995.
Wow, this has never happened. This is the third time today I had three different people that had the same card. Now, you're the second Jack of Clubs.
Okay. That's crazy.
That is crazy, but you're a Taurus Jack of Clubs, so that means you're more stubborn.
Oh, am I?
Yeah. See, the other Jack of Clubs that I read, he's more two-faced, a little two-sided, a little more forgiving, but yeah, you're more stubborn Jack of Clubs. So that means when you see something that you really want, you're gonna find a way to get it, and you're gonna use your words to get it. I don't know if you take advantage of that, but you have that power to get to use your words to get what you want. Like the other person, you definitely speak your truth with authority. You get along well with cats. You know what I mean? You're the kind of person that although you're gonna say what you gotta say, you tend to get along with people. People respect what you say, don't they? They've always respected what you say.
Yeah, when I do talk, I don't talk a lot, but when I do.
Yeah. You respect, you're creative too.
Yes, lifelong artist.
Yeah, your creativity, you have a lot of value in your creativity, like values. When you want some things, okay, that you create, you create things that mean something.
Right.
Go ahead.
Oh yeah, I was just saying, because it's like I want to do something that's worthwhile with my art and try to like help other people and things like that. But it's just been kind of difficult trying to get around different, I guess, internal obstacles.
Okay, here's your internal obstacle. Let me tell you exactly. I see the internal obstacles. Let me tell you where they are. You judge yourself too much. See that Mercury 9 diamonds? You overthink it. That's your biggest issue with your art. You're trying to create your art from your head. You can't. That's not where you create it from. You see where that Saturn card, that Jack of Diamonds, you're in that Uranus four of hearts. Your creativity is supposed to come from your heart, and you're so self-critical that you deem your creations from your heart is less than. You judge it, and you've been trying to create art that other people are gonna like versus what's coming through your heart. You have to let that go. You overthink it too. You be in your head too much, dog. For real. You be thinking it too hard. Like, that's why you're having the issue that you're having. You're trying to create, right now, I can see right now that Nine of Diamonds, you're trying to communicate to people something that you think other people are going to like. You can't do that. You got to get to the point in your art to where you can't find a fuck to give about what the next person thinks. You're never going to be free as an artist. Because your art has have jest in your art. When I say jest, it's a little funny. It's gonna be some stuff that's gonna make you like laugh, kind of, don't it?
Yeah, yeah.
You know how to express comedically within your art and through suggestion.
I've done some political cartoons, so yeah.
Yeah, that's where you at, yo. You got some out of there ability. You have some out of there ideas, like, that are kind of out the park. You have to think in terms, and plus, you right there, born 95. Your art can't look like what's been done before. If you're trying to do what's been done before, you ain't gonna make it.
Got it.
You gotta move forward. And when I say moving forward, four hearts, Uranus, it's gonna be something that feels good to you. It's gonna feel good to you to do. But then your biggest issue, now you're gonna have to get there. Like, once it feels good to you, what always happens when something that feels good to you comes along, the next thing that happens is you start thinking about it and you start overanalyzing it and you start cutting it and crafting it and changing it and moving it. And then that's where your conflict is. Create from pure heart.
Thanks, because it really helps a lot. Because I could just imagine one time I had a drawing I was doing of a character, and I just kept changing things over and over, and it never really did anything with it afterwards.
Yeah, once you finish change, okay, so that day happened. Yeah, you changed up. I'm sure you didn't recognize what it was after all them changes. It wasn't what your heart was on when you first put the character out there, was it? So yeah, you're gonna have to get to the part to where you trust yourself and you trust your heart. You have a good heart. So you gotta understand that whatever comes out of it is gonna be good. Okay? Don't overthink it.
Okay. Thank you.
For sure.
Helps a lot.
Yes, sir. You have a good one.
You too.
See, that's why I like doing this on air in front of y'all, man. This ain't no game. I gotta say, it's for entertainment purposes. I hope you guys are entertained. But yeah.
Are you not entertained?
Drake Champagne Poppy is not. All that glitters ain't gold. So to everybody. Everybody that's out there, don't believe what the perception you see of what you see on TV. It's all a game. All right? What also I need y'all to do is to go to breakthroughcards.com. For those of you, the discount code for my listeners only is 30. 30. Book it this week for 30% off all readings, hour and above, hour and a half. And also my three reading package. I have a three reading package I do. For those of you who like regular readings, you want 30% off three readings, the three reading package is also 30% off, all right? Book now at breakthroughcards.com. All that good stuff. See, all these 30% off right now. Thank you to my students for cardiology class. We'll have our next class will be in a couple weeks, all right? Well, remember this. I'm about to be up out of here. There are no perfect messengers, only perfect messages for those willing to pick up the game. My name is Juan. I'm out.